Inheritance is a mechanism by which one software entity, such as a class, can inherit implementation from another software entity. Inheritance also provides a weak mechanism for abstraction in the programming sense of this word abstraction. In this video, I will explain what I just said using some useful examples, and we will also learn how to use inheritance in Java to improve our code. But before we get to that, I need to teach you a bit about how type hierarchies work so that you can become familiar with the basic terms and definitions within the topic of inheritance. In part 2 of this course, I introduced the idea of type theory, so I will be assuming you are somewhat familiar with what I mean by classes and types. Building on those ideas, type theory is essentially the process of classifying different things based on what is or is not common between them. Now, be aware that I use the word class and type somewhat interchangeably when we are not talking about Java classes specifically. Type theory is also a way of describing the relationships between these different classifications. While I normally try to avoid jargon, there are some common words that programmers use to describe these relationships, and I would be setting you up for confusion and embarrassment if I did not introduce you to them. Here we have a basic classification of different exercises. At the top of our class hierarchy is what we call the base or root class, and it can be thought of as the point of commonality among all of these classes. Below, we have what we call child classes or subclasses of exercise. Both terms are commonly used. Notice how when I described them, I explicitly said that they were child classes of exercise. That is because, relative to the classes below them, we would call them parent classes or superclasses. In case you are wondering what sub and super mean, they are Latin prepositions for under and above. These are the most commonly described relationships, but some people will also say that cat stretch is a grandchild of exercise, or that aerobic exercise is the aunt or uncle of cat stretch. We could also say that running and walking are siblings. To return to a Java-specific discussion, OOP languages are designed to build these kinds of class hierarchies, so much so that we use the word class to describe an object in a hierarchy. Please open up the source code for Part 4, Section 2 in the demo repository. As an example, what we have here is a representation of that same class hierarchy. Simply by using the extends keyword, we can indicate a parent and child or super and subclass relationship. This relationship is known as inheritance, and the extends keyword is how you implement inheritance in your code in Java. The effect of this is that any non-private variable or method will be accessible to the inheriting class even though they are not defined within the body of the inheriting class. Let us look at a quick example. Here we have created a new object from the squats class, and because squats inherits from exercise, which defines a getExerciseName method, we can use that method to print the name. Whenever a superclass requires some kind of arguments, such as exerciseName, we need some kind of way to have the subclass pass these arguments from its constructor to the constructor of the superclass. The way to achieve this is by using a special reserved method called super. When you call this method, it will invoke the constructor of the next superclass up, and it expects the appropriate arguments for that constructor. In hierarchies with multiple descendants like this, you may need to make several subsequent calls to super in order for the arguments to satisfy the constructors of every class in the hierarchy. This method is also used to invoke overridden methods, but we will look at that when we get to abstract classes. As should be clear at this point, we use inheritance when we want to share implementation between a set of classes. To be specific, by implementation, I mean variables and methods, including method bodies. When we build desktop or mobile applications in Java, we inherit basic user interface implementations from platform libraries like Swing, JavaFX, or the Android SDK. For example, the entry point for my Sudoku application is actually a class which extends application from JavaFX. This class contains implementations for interacting with the operating system to start and stop the application, and it also gives me access to this stage object, which represents the primary window of an application. As you can see, inheritance is an extraordinarily useful tool which can save us an extraordinary amount of time. Although inheritance is mostly a mechanism for sharing implementation, it can also work as what I like to call a weak mechanism for abstraction. You will hopefully understand what I mean by weak after I explain the next concept, interfaces, which I call a strong mechanism for abstraction. However, let me be a bit more specific about what abstraction means in the context of programming languages. Abstraction means hiding some details of a class, variable, or even a method from the parts of the system which use them. Now, anyone who has built a complicated system will understand this intuitively, but I recall from my early days asking the question, when is having less details ever a good thing? We will look at several situations both in this part of the course and the next part to demonstrate this to you in code. For now, let us look at a very simple yet very practical example of abstraction using inheritance. Before proceeding, please open up the file called Inheritance Starter in the demo repository. There are two goals for this exercise. We want to be able to place several different kinds of exercises in the same data structure. Secondly, we want to iterate through the data structure and print out the different names of each exercise. Let us start by creating some new exercises. Next, we will create a list of exercises. We will use an ArrayList data structure, which is less memory efficient than a normal array, but much simpler to work with in many cases. Now, in case you are wondering, yes, ArrayList is a child of the list interface. This is beside the point of this example, but a good general rule is to keep your reference types as abstract as possible. That does not mean you must always use the abstract type. Sometimes the details do become important. Now, the real magic happens here. As you can see, even though we specify that this is a list of type exercise, every type here is a descendant. The key point is that as far as our list data structure is concerned, it does not know or care what the actual type is. Earlier I said that we should, as a general rule, reference types by their most abstract reference that still allows the program to function. Now we will print out each argument. This is a very rudimentary example, and some of you may still be unconvinced of the power of abstraction, but I am far from done. Like I said before, inheritance is actually a weak form of abstraction, but it is a great way to share implementation.